is though, like, real, like, I'm not gonna say he's the most talented player I played with, because I played with some crazy people, but like, he's probably like, he's definitely.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
There. You yeah. said the name.
Blah blah blah.
In high school basketball, he is. Like, in, organized.
Yeah. Wait, was RH not good at basketball?
Who?
RH.
Oh, he was. I'm just saying he didn't look like it.
I thought you were talking about the younger one.
No.
Bro, prime RH. Prime younger RH. Oh,
prime RH.
Younger RH.
He was cold, yeah. He was
younger RH. You know who I'm talking about?
Is he on the team now?
Abe, can you just mute it? No, he was a senior last year. He didn't play. Or junior.
Senior last year. Where did I check in on the Discord? Sorry.
H-U-B.
H-U-B.
You probably forgot him, I would say, honestly.
Oh, that one?
Fuck it. The turnaround double clutch jump shot.
No. I told him this so much. He could have been like, he could have been crazy at hurdles.
He could have. I saw him run track. He was really fast.
See the way he runs, bro? Yeah. No, like the way he runs, like, he runs goofy, bro. Like, goofy as hell.
He runs kind of like Milan.
I don't know how Milan runs, so I don't know.
You played basketball at the same time as Milan, though.
I was never on his team.
Yeah, but he played JV.
Oh, well, I don't watch those games, but it's okay. Like, no, our team, we actually won a playoff game, too. That's a great, like, we won a CIF game.
We, like, we're good, but we sucked.
We were actually not that bad.
We were good, but
I sucked at the time. Yeah.
Okay, do you want to talk about that year and everything happening with Jaden that year or no?
Well, I mean, we can, because sophomore year was not a movie, I'll tell you that.
And anytime, let me know if you want me to cut shit out, but you tell me junior year that year you're considering quitting basketball.
Yeah, so sophomore year was basically like roller coaster of emotions for me, because like going into it, I was like, okay, like all these guys are whack, all these guys are sorry, like it's whatever though, because it's the school, like I'm here now, like I can't do anything about it, and so like I'm just kind of hooping, like that's what I've always done, I just hoop. And then basically, you know how our coach is, he's like, oh, if you do this and this, like you'll get minutes. And I was like, dude, I've been doing that the whole year. But
oh, okay, so I'm sorry, I gotta mention this. I just remembered this last night. Like, yeah. After that year, he said I would play 22 minutes next year, just off of playing defense.
I knew it was you who he said that to.
Wait, who?
Because Tyler brought that up the other day. No, because,
yeah.
And then Tyler brought up how, like, one of the it was your to you. Or, that our coach made to you. Like, yeah,
you also gotta cut out the
but no, like, yeah, that's I knew he was talking about you, but I had to ask him afterward. there we go.
So yeah, I got that promise. It wasn't really a promise, but I'll tell you, he was like, okay, so play defense and you get these minutes, and I was like, eh.
Yeah, no, yeah.
And obviously the next year I didn't like actually play like at all, basically. Like, well, what Chris I has will now.
Tell you, yeah, what I will tell you is that I can't, like, I was never gonna, like, I was never angry at him for like why he didn't play me my sophomore year, because it was like I just felt he was asking too much of me at the time.
I wasn't angry about him benching me junior year too, because I sucked and my head wasn't even in basketball.
So junior year, at the start of the year, if you notice, I would not have started if I didn't play well that like fall season or whatever. Like, literally wasn't gonna start me, and then I just went crazy.
Yeah,
fall season.
But can finish your sophomore year. Like, talk.
Yeah, so sophomore year though, like basically it was kind of just like I was kind of sitting behind someone who was like I was better than, and it was like. Pretty freaking obvious, and now, but I mean, at the time it wasn't, just because like.
Can I ask, are you talking about second unit or first unit person? Are you talking about like San Diego time when it was like.
Wait, who are you sitting by?
I think, right?
Oh, put him in the chat, yeah. Oh, it was like, Dave, you know, everyone got like, I'm pretty sure I didn't start playing, like starting until the Ocean View tournament, because he didn't play like one game in the Ocean View tournament.
He didn't? Yeah, you look at the chat, right? Right person?
I sent it. Oh, what chat?
Bot.
Oh, I put it in general.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was looking at
both. Yeah, it was that. I was looking in general, but it's fine. No, but like, it's kind of like how, like, me and Tyler talk about this all the time, because Tyler feels the same way. He feels that he was better than, like, a lot of people in the starting lineup, and yeah, I felt that I was better than one person that I could start over in the starting lineup. I'll talk about that. That makes sense.
That whole time, I was like, I wanted to quit basketball, I was depressed, and then Tyler came off the bench for me, and I did not understand that at all.
Yeah, but I mean,
no, I'm not even gonna defend myself that year. Like,
no. Yeah, but it's like, I just feel like you should have that role now on this team. That would be so much better now.
Yeah, that's what I don't understand. I'll go on that rant like one day.
But I don't understand either, but
I'm okay with letting it all slip away. Yeah,
I mean, no, so like, yeah, just like going back to that, it was kind of just like. It was just hard not understanding why I was playing behind this guy. But I mean, at the same time, the minutes I was playing, I didn't play well. So I got that.
Yeah.
It was just like frustrating, because it was like I was playing like crap. And that was the only way I could like do something about it. But it was like I wasn't showing him that I could like he could trust me on the court, if that makes sense. That's the whole thing that like people don't understand is like, what the fuck? That's the whole thing, like our team, like most of our team doesn't understand still, is like once you build trust with them, once he can trust you on the court, it's like gives you free will. You can do whatever.
Like Junior, you were talking to me about how you didn't have that trust. It's still, so is this at the point where you're like considering like
so the point I considered quitting was sophomore year. After the San Diego tournament, that's when I was going to quit.
Yeah. Transfer. I remember you mentioning, like, you were coming off, like, you were, like, the 11th man in the San Diego tournament.
I was just, like, depressed, because it was, like, frustrating just watching guys play over me that I was better than. But it was, like, it just felt like I couldn't do anything about it at that point, because I wasn't playing well either. So
there was, that's really also, no, like, when the freshman moved up.
That is when the freshmen move up.
That's weird calling them freshmen.
I know. That just pissed me off even more, because it's like, dude, these guys are starting and they just came off their freshman team and I still don't play. And it's like, these kids.
Never talk about freshman Dave on here. Triple double machine.
That's for another time.
Wait, are you driving right now?
Dude, I should probably go
to school. Yeah, I have to go to school.
Oh shit, school's in 10 minutes.
No, it's in 25.
No, it's oh, it is.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's at 10:30. Wait, Dave. Hold
up, sorry. You guys showing up to class?
All right, wait, see,
fine. It's fine. It's what's it called? Service learning.
So you could leave Ridwan, but Arjun, you want to keep on doing this, or you want to cut it off here and start it again later?
No, we could keep going.
Okay, are you good, Jaden? Like,
I'm straight. I'm gonna just. We can keep talking, but at some point I'm going to disconnect and hop on my phone.
Okay.
That helps.
So, where were we on? Okay, so, fucking, what did I say? Oh, Corona fucking happens, and then you come back junior year. We could just skip over the Corona period unless there's anything important you want to talk about. Junior year, you come...
Like,
are you gonna say something?
I guess, like, let's see, because what happened that year? I guess one thing we can talk about is, like, I basically, if you didn't know, I had a meeting about it. Like,
I remember that, because like, we were having a shooting practice. It was
me, yeah,
ATRH, Jay and your brother, Arjun. And he pulled you into that room for like an hour. And I was like, what the fuck?
For an hour? No, and hold on. Let me see. I think I'm going to join on my phone right now. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. So, okay, she's still speaking right now, so you guys aren't going to start, like, already. End of the year, you're getting some PT, but junior year is where you make, like, your real jump, and then you go from a bench player to becoming the team captain in 1 year. So, like, what happened through that time? And then talk about, like, the responsibility that you gained or you had junior year.
Hold on, give me a second. I'm walking out of the house. Okay. So, one thing we can talk about is, like, I basically started to get minutes actually, like, during CIF, right?
Before that, rivalry games.
Hold on. I'm an idiot. Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right, I disconnected from my ear. But no, so, like, basically, I pretty much started getting minutes in CIF and, like, the game is right before CIF.
Damn, you cut out. Arjun, you still there?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I'm here.
When, that's pretty much, like, when I, like, that's the time to get better. That's when I have to get on my shit.
Oh, I haven't heard what you've been saying for the last 15 seconds. You cut out.
Oh, my fucking car's in my car. But no, I was just, like, saying how, like, the summer is, like, the time that I understand is, like, when I have to make that jump every year. And it was, like, I think that was the biggest I made just because I grew a little bit, and then I got a little stronger, and I was able to, like, shoot the ball consistently with, like the strength that I gained a little bit, and it was, like, it made it easier for me to play, and it just made it easier just, like, understanding that our coach actually, like, saw what I was doing and, like kind of understood what I can do now versus, like, that sophomore year, he was kind of just like, he kind of just didn't understand what I could do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm sorry. Just for pacing, I got to speed this up. So you have a really good junior year. The team does good. You're the captain. You're the captain again senior year, obviously, and you're still doing good. So talk about your recruiting process and everything with that.
With college, dude, are you talking about that or high school stuff?
Like, you're in high school, but you're, like, looking into college for basketball.
Looking into college. So it's looking pretty, like, what I can say from here is, like, it looks like it's going to be pretty good chances of playing college, which is good.
Is it where I'm thinking? Not, like,
it probably isn't where you're thinking, actually. That's still one of the schools that I've been talking to, but I've been communicating with a lot, like, quite a few schools still, which is good. And it's just, like, that's, like, something that'll always, like, have my confidence up because I never even thought I could even play at the level, to be honest.
Yeah.
Just because, like, I was, like, it wasn't even, like, certain that I would even play high school basketball, you know what I'm saying? That's my whole thing. So that's why, like, as you said before, I don't have little man syndrome just because, like, I kind of appreciate that I'm here at this point. It's, yeah, like, I didn't even think I could get this far.
You really, like, you're not gonna see many, like, 5'5" Asian people making that jump, so
no,
you're gonna make that next transition, so I don't know. Yeah. How are you getting ready for it?
Obviously I have to get a little meat on these bones, get a little stronger, but just, like, continuing to work and then, like, just again, like, just kind of keep that chip on my shoulder because that's how I have to be at the size I am. And, like, it is hard, but it really just makes it 10 times easier for me just because, like, I have something to play for all the time.
Okay.
And it's like, yeah.
Yeah, so you're about to finish your high school career. How do you, like, look back on everything wrapped up?
Dude, like, I honestly wouldn't change it.
There's still more. There's
like
your senior, even, wait, Jaden.
Yeah.
Like, even in your senior year, you still wanted to quit at, like, one, like,
yeah,
certain
week. There is a point. Yeah, Dave, if you didn't know, I was thinking about quitting this year.
I was told. You didn't tell me, but I was told through the grapevine.
Yeah. Yeah, through the grapevine. You were told that I was going to quit this year. I was going to quit this year. I was a text message away from quitting.
Yeah.
But I didn't quit somehow. I don't know how. And it was just, like, hard, and, like, just because, like, I was the senior now, and it was, like, I didn't have any older guys to, like, look to, like, take the pressure off of me, you know what I'm saying? Because it was, like, back then we had, like, RH, and we had CG, and then we even had, like, AN, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But, you know, you always have, like, big brother Dave.
I know, we always have Dave.
Dean.
But, I mean... There's only so much you can do too, and it was like
I was trolling. It was just, can't do anything.
Nah, you definitely have done something because I'm still fucking here somehow.
I appreciate it.
But like, no, like I just wanted to like get away from all like the like it was at the point where it was like basketball was like a distraction to my life at that point, and I was trying to focus on what I really wanted, but at the same time, like basketball is always what I like want to do. So
I got it.
And it's yeah, but I don't know. I was gonna quit, but I didn't because I don't piss you out of shit.
Yeah. So I don't want to talk about the senior year right now because it's still happening and we don't know how to end, but. So yeah, wrap it up all in a bow, and then I'll ask the ending questions, and we'll be out of here.
What up?
Like your whole high school career, it's about to end. How do you look back on it? You know,
back on it. Well, I mean, like, I kind of just like was like I kind of just appreciated the opportunities I was getting because it was like. At the start of it, I was like,
"Is this you behind me?
What's up, bitch? Oh my God. Drive slow as hell, bro.
No, bro. I left literally like 3 minutes after your
facts. I'm behind you, but no, like,
oh fuck, I said
but no, like, I guess, like I said earlier, I'm just like, I just appreciate the opportunity that I have to like keep going. And it's like, at the end of the day, like nothing's ever like you can't take things for granted because like it's cheesy, but tomorrow's not like guaranteed, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm about to blow by this bitch. Suck my
dick. You're a bitch. You're a bitch. Oh my God. I'm beating you to Sage. Watch this shit. Nah, watch this shit.
The toll road?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you. I wasn't going to take a toll road. I'll take the toll road again.
Okay. So,
bye, Jaden.
I'm still here. What's up, Dave?
Where do you see yourself in 10 years? And then just what's your favorite basketball memory? And then we're done.
Well, in 10 years, I hope I have a baddie on my side. Mm-hmm. I would love to have a baddie on my side. You know what I'm saying? Because,
yeah.
Like, at that time, I gotta stop for toes and I have to lock out one. You know what I'm saying? So that's a must. But I just like whatever I'm doing, I just hope I'm happy doing it. Like,
yeah.
Because it's like, I don't know about you guys, but so like the money doesn't really fucking like, no, I'm not really pushed and like motivated by money. So
Okay, you're talking to like the exact opposite mentality.
That's Dave is the CEO of Money Hungry and doesn't care about shit else.
So, but
it's okay.
So, what's your favorite basketball memory? And then you can end it.
Favorite basketball memory. See, favorite basketball memory would probably be like. There's been a lot of fucking crazy ones, but maybe like, I guess we could say like, this Nuggets game we won at their gym last year was pretty fucking cool.
Yeah, especially you hitting all that shit. And you said the name. It's okay, but yeah.
God damn it, Jaden, you're the worst.
This is gonna be so hard to edit, but this is a fire podcast. Thank you for coming on as always, Jaden.
This was a wadcast, bro. Thank you. I didn't even say shit.
Yeah, how you want to end this?
Jaden has big balls in Arjun Bhakta's mouth.
Oh, favorite player. What's your favorite player?
Oh, what's my favorite player?
Oh, shit, I'm 102.
Arjun going 102, bro. Fuck this. I'm not winning. Favorite player, it used to be Chris Paul until I fucking started hating the way he played. So I hate Chris Paul now. And my favorite player right now would probably be like, okay, it's pretty obvious the way I play. It'd probably be like Trae Young, dude. Like, I fucking love watching the way that guy plays.
Okay.
Like, I literally nutmeg people all the time because of it. Like, come on now.
Okay, bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye.
See you, Jaden. Also, Jaden, you're not going to win. Wait, don't leave yet.
I'm not winning.
Or Dave, you can leave. I don't care. Bye-bye. But Jaden can suck my fat.